Hello, welcome to Jim and Tay Have Their Say. Today I'm going to take the lead again, twice in a row, and I'm going to ask you a question, which has to do with physical endurance.
Okay.
What is the thing that you've done this lifetime that required the most, toughest, longest, whatever, physical endurance challenge?
When I had to swim across that big field.
Yes. What are you talking about? You're hallucinating.
I'm just joking. The physical endurance.
I thought you had something right off the bat.
Yeah, yeah.
What comes to mind?
I mean, just dancing, I guess.
A particular time? A particular dance?
No, all the time.
It was always demanding.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you did like solos and you did group numbers.
Doesn't make any difference.
Doesn't make, I would think that it would, but no.
No, you're still dancing just as much.
Hmm. Because you've not been a big hiker or biker.
That's
or
also
like
not that hard.
What?
Hiking? That's not like, I mean, granted, I've never been one to go on like 8-mile hikes, yeah. But.
Yeah. Some people hike and it is.
Yeah, but I've never done that. So if you're asking me a question that, what's my hardest physical endurance?
Yeah, okay. Right, right.
It's dancing.
Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, good. Well, thank you for watching, everybody.
What about you? Do you have something you want to share?
Well, I mean, I hadn't thought of anything. Oh. But since you ask, I mean, I was thinking, when I would think of your youth, I think of you as working out a lot. We would take you to dance class, and although we weren't privy to what you were doing there, we assumed that you were working very hard. And then when we saw the dance shows, we realized that you had been working super hard. You were super limber. You could dance for, I don't know, it seemed like over an hour with the whole show, and rushing around and quickly, and afterward you would be just gloriously sweaty,
mm-hmm.
and your makeup would be all sparkly and runny, and your clothes would be soaked, and it was like, wow, this is a person who's really expending a lot of energy to create a dramatic effect or an aesthetic effect. So it was like, I'm proud of that. I think that's great. In my case, you know, I've sort of gravitated away from doing too many physical endurance things, although in my life, of course, I have gone on hikes, I have gone on
things like that. Yeah, but I feel like you've been more I mean, now I didn't know you earlier, but at least from the stories, it seems like you've been more physically active in the later part of your life, which is interesting.
Like, yeah,
now
yeah.
You go to the gym regularly, mm-hmm. you exercise mm-hmm. quite a bit more. I mean,
mm-hmm. go on long walks and hikes and stuff. So I'm not terribly demanding on myself, but I do go to the gym. I work out with a trainer, and it's all safe and everything. And I never push myself too hard because there's no profit in that.
Yeah.
But I do like to walk, and sometimes, like when I went to Rome, I walked every day. I had a lot of free time. I was by myself.
And you walked a lot in New York, I guess, when you lived in New
always
York.
Walked a lot always in New walking. York. Yeah. And but I don't know, physical. Like I'm not the kind of guy, I guess, who's tested myself. I've never been like some people go and they want to be mountain climbers and they want to go to Everest or they want to go to Kilimanjaro or they want to go to even local mountains here and really see if they can do the endurance, or they want to do a marathon.
Yeah, they have to actually, like, you're like talking about something where you really build you have to build up that endurance.
Yeah, like our friend Michael Dovin, who goes and he does Ironman things and like, oh my God, you know, that's something where I think in the back of your mind, you have to be thinking, maybe I can't do this, but I'm going to prove to myself that I can, and it's going to take everything I have.
Right.
And I don't ever get into that kind of situation.
No, I think it sounds cool, but I think I have a lot of other things that I want to do more than build up my stamina.
Yeah.
But I do think it's very healthy.
A lot of respect for it.
A lot of respect for it. Yeah. It takes a lot of hard work and a gradient approach.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, we just do other stuff.
We do other stuff.
But we still like to move.
Absolutely like to move and create. I like to do a show. I like to wear myself out and see if I can say all those lyrics in this amount of time before the music runs out. I like, sometimes back before I was training, actually, there were times when I was doing certain numbers in my act and I was like, all right, I got to really manage my breathing because I do not want to faint or pass out in the middle of this song.
Wow.
And I think now I'm healthy enough to, I don't have that consideration anymore. But back in the, even 10 years ago, I was like, okay, I'm really expending a lot of air here. I'm outflowing a lot. I'm exhaling a lot and I'm getting just a tiny bit lightheaded and I got to manage that. I got to make sure that I breathe enough. And now I don't seem to have that problem
that's
anymore.
That's great. So, I understand
that's my marathon.
You've been working hard. It's great. I mean, I love it. Now I do the jump roping, which is the best. Mm-hmm. But also, I don't know if I could like run a long time or something. I don't, it's a different kind of stamina.
Run, but swim, fire a bow and arrow, chase an elk through the woods.
What do you like to do to get yourself in shape? And is it important to you? Let us know in the comments below. And thanks for watching our show.
Have you noticed any improvement? Let us know about that too.
Bye.